Okay, time for us to kick off our 7 o'clock hour. With us on the phone, we have Michigan Filmmaker of the Year, Rich Brower from Manistee. How you doing, Rich?
Good morning, Mary. How are you?
Well, I am delighted you've brought a friend with you this morning to talk
sure
with
do.
Us.
Renee O'Connor's with me on the phone.
Renee?
Morning, Mary.
Oh, I'm suddenly a Xena Princess Warrior.
Yes, you are.
Rich, what in the world are you doing with Renee O'Connor?
Well, we have made this new film, and we're just a couple of days from wrapping, but it's a story about this young professional woman who kind of gets trapped on this spooky ship with a lot of suspense and a lot of dark comedy. And I've not met Renee before this shoot, but when I was kind of going down this list that our casting company presented, all of a sudden this Renee, are you kidding, Renee O'Connor? We love Renee O'Connor. And I talked to her, she saw the script, and I know she got the dark comedy of it, because she cracks up at the right places.
Thank goodness, someone who gets it. So, Renee, how did you first see the script? What was your reaction?
Oh, I loved the dark comedy, and I just thought, it definitely had to be directed by the same person who wrote it. I just knew that, and so I was so, because it's a very particular tone, and I just cracked up. It takes a little perfect perversity that is fun, you know. You'll like it. It's good.
Well, so this has been shot entirely in the Manistee area?
Yeah, well, we've been, we're mostly on the SS City of Milwaukee, but we're going to be kind of floating around town a little bit the next couple of days, but absolutely all right here in Manistee. And it was definitely written for this ship. I've been a part of this boat for 30 some years, and it's I knew about it a lot. I've sailed on it a lot. I was on its last voyage, so I'm pretty intimate with this thing, and I kind of knew where all the skeletons were buried, so to speak. So it's kind of like it's a story that was written for a specific location.
Well, very cool. In fact, there's an event coming up on the SS Milwaukee, a ghost ship ride for Halloween that we're going to be talking to Linda Spencer later this morning about.
So they have been a fantastic host for us.
Have they
and,
really?
And we promised to get out of their way before a ghost ship started, so we've done that.
I don't think they need to set anything up in there. There were plenty of little plenty of personalities already lingering on the ship, you know.
Well, Renee, tell me how you like being in Michigan.
Oh, I loved it, actually. Talking about the ship was such an incredible sense of history of the area. And then with Rich along explaining some of the stories of the different ships that have gone through, and just his tales of filmmaking have been quite extraordinary. And then on top of that, to have the sense of family that are part of his team has just been quite humbling. You know, it's been such a gracious group and extremely creative.
Well, and you own your own production company as well, so you know what Rich is going through.
Well, I do. You know, I appreciate his loyalty to his team, and then their sense of loyalty back to him. And you know, that comes with years of experience and years of collaboration.
Now, Renee, you have a co-star in this that very recognizable. Tell folks about him.
About Larry?
Yeah.
Oh, Larry's hilarious. you know, it's funny because I wasn't aware of him that much, but as soon as he walked on and I just had a sense of his personality and his sense of humor, we immediately clicked.
Right, this is Larry
Joe. We've been working together for years.
Larry Joe Campbell is who we're speaking of, and he plays the character on According to Jim with Jim Belushi. He's his affable sidekick, you could say.
Yes.
And what a funny guy.
And what I think is amazing is to see these two actors work together, because Larry is I don't know, 200 and, I don't know, hopefully he's not listening right now, but he's got to be 260 or something like that. And then here's this sweet little Renee, who's this cute little thin...
See, I am listening now. Go ahead.
Okay, yeah. And did I say beautiful?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. And so that's what's funny, though, is that this huge juxtaposition between these two characters, and one of them, of course, plays this very apprehensive resident, and the other one is this completely entrenched caretaker of this ship.
So,
so you get these two very distant personalities working together, and then they have to come to terms with each other, and that's where the the rubber hits the road a little bit.
Excellent. We're going to take a little break here. When we come back, we'll continue our conversation with Rich Brower and Renee O'Connor. Going to find out what is it like those last few days before you have to wrap up a film and how soon we can see it. We'll be back with more of Mary in the Morning right after this. Well, and we especially want to say good morning to our friends in Manistee because we're talking with some visitors to their area right now. We have Michigan Filmmaker of the Year, Rich Brower of Brower Productions, also Renee O'Connor. Who I understand is the thin, beautiful, lovely star.
Yeah, well, yeah, something like that, right?
Yeah.
Here's the thing. The beautiful thing, ultimately, is the spirit that Renee exudes. And so that's what's going on here. She has a knack for acting. She's very good at this stuff. And so it's really fun to watch her get herself into these situations on this creepy ship that she's completely the fish out of water in. And there was a scene we shot last week that ran for 3 minutes or so. And I swear I did not take a breath when I was shooting this. It was all of a sudden over with, and then I realized I hadn't taken any air in, and I was probably going to pass out. But it was because it was so eerie.
Yeah.
It's like walking into a room that's a little bit dark, and there's a coat hanging on a hook over in the corner, and you know perfectly well it's your coat, but for a little moment, there's the hair stands up on the back of your head, and you question that. And that's kind of what's going on a lot.
Yeah, the name of the movie is Fitful, and Rich, tell us, what is the premise that gets the character on the ship?
Renee plays Paula, who works for the National Trust, and her job is to do preservation projects around the country, I guess. And she gets a call late on Friday that's from her boss and says, hey, would you mind, you're kind of in the neighborhood, would you mind checking out this ship? It's kind of on your way home anyway to Chicago. And she goes, oh, yeah, sure. So she takes this creepy little road down 15 miles of two-track and gets into this marina, kind of an industrial boatyard kind of place, and then her car gets disabled, and she can't walk 15 miles in the dark and back to town, and so she decides to take this fellow up on his offer to spend the night, and it begins a journey for her.
Fabulous.
But this is not a slasher, you know, kind of that kind of violence. It's nothing like that. This is 100% suspense-driven.
Awesome. So how's the suspense of leading up to wrapping up the shoot?
I'm going to miss these guys. I've been photographing Renee and Larry for this whole time, and when I go back to my little world, although I'm shooting something else next Monday, I just found out, but I'm going to miss seeing these guys in the viewfinder, you know?
Yeah.
And so I'm going to miss it. I always miss it at this point. It's kind of like, for me anyway, maybe the crew can't wait to get out of here, but I'm kind of sentimental about this stuff, and so, we've had a real good go of it. The weather's been great. The ship's been fantastic. The acting's been great. The stunts, hey, Renee, you should talk about the shower scene. That'd be a good one.
The shower scene? Excuse me?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. What kind of movie
is this? Mary, because I know that you were trying to get into this movie.
I was.
And, at least tried to audition for this movie.
I did.
Lucky, Mary.
I did it in the shower for Rich.
Thankfully, you were.
Yeah.
No, it's a shower full of eels. So, like, you know, I think, what was the rig that you and Jed created? Some sort of splurginator?
It was a JB 1000 eel spooginator.
It's going to be marketed next week.
Yeah, for anybody who wants to shoot eels across your shower stall.
Now you know how.
We can talk to us.
I'll put it
on eBay, and because it had anything to do with Renee O'Connor, it'll probably be worth a fortune.
Absolutely. All right, so guys, when can we see this movie?
Christmas.
Christmas.
It's a Christmas story.
In Traverse City?
Oh, yep. I'm sure I'll have it done around Christmas, and we'll try to make it available for everybody to come and enjoy. And it's completely different than a lot of the stuff I've done before. This is a complete departure, but I think the comedy is solid, and it's dark, and this thing is going to really be, a fun ride.
Excellent. Cool. Well, you guys, thanks so much for starting your day with us. This was really great to check in with you. And so if the next movie you do does not include a shower full of eels, I'd like my agent to call you.
Like a crack at it?
Yeah. Yeah, I really would. All right, guys, thanks so much. Good luck with your wrap.
Okay, Mary.
All right.
For having us on.
Sure. Okay, we'll be back with more of Mary in the Morning right after this.